Hello miners, today I'm going to show you how to configure Athos and by using Claymore and Nanopool and start mining with your GPUs and top up your hardware wallet or your wallet with exchanges or other third parties. Now, what is Athos? Athos is an operating system based on Ubuntu. With all the tools you need to do that job, it's very easy to configure and it's very flexible related to drivers for Nvidia and AMD, now supporting both in the, with the version 1.2.7. But first let's see how you can buy Athos. So if you go to gpusac.com, as you see here, there are a couple of options. There are some options if you want to buy a bundle, like including CPU, MOB or RAM, with of course the appropriate price. And then you have some other options like to buy USB or just download the Athos zip file, but you need another tool in Windows to unzip it and take out the ISO file, and then hard code it to push it to your SSD or your USB. Ideally is to use SSD drive because of course it's much faster. Also USB is going to work, but depends how many cards you have. And if you have of course many cards, probably you have some delays and you don't want to lose hashes because of the USB connection. Now in another video I will show you how to uncompress Athos and how to put it in SSD and load it for the first time, but I did it already. And when you load the video, the Athos, the first screen you will see on your TV or your monitor will be this. So this is the first screen. So there are some very important information here, like for example the version, which Athos version you're using. So for example this one is 1.2.6, but the current one is 1.2.7. How many GPUs you have, here you will see also how many minutes your rig is up, and also your rig name. I will show you later how to change it. Also you can see the IP. This is very important for the first time. So now depends if you have Windows, Mac or Linux to connect to your Athos. So you need SSH client. In Windows you can use the many SSH clients, but you can use which one is suitable to you. On Mac and terminal is available natively, so you can just open the terminal and SSH to your rig. Next one is the memory. You can see how much memory you have, how much memory you're using, and how much memory is free, and also the CPU. So for the CPU you don't need a lot of power, like Intel Celeron is enough to run your whole rig. You don't have to worry too much for the CPU. For the memory is different. If you have many cards, it's good to have more than 8 gig memory. The next one is the cards you have. So this will be different in your case, so, but maybe you have one card, maybe you have two cards, depends on your rig, but you will be able to see how many hashes you do, and also a couple of information for the GPU and a summary of your hashes. So this will be the first screen when you launch Athos. And What we need now, we need the IP, the IP to connect to Ethos and start configuring. So I will open in the browser and also the terminal. So in the browser, the first time, because you didn't set up the miner name yet, and maybe you don't want you to connect to the, if you don't want to connect to the web interface, you can open your browser. You can type the IP which we've seen in the previous screen on the initial monitor. So if, for example, here, so you just type this IP in your browser, and then you get to the login page. The first here letters and numbers is the name of your rig. By default, Ethos is using user Ethos, and password is live. So when you type this, you can access your Ethos without using SSH client. You just go straight from your browser. You can see here is I have access. You can see the files. So if you are comfortable to use the browser, yeah, feel free to use it. The alternatively, you can use the SSH. In Mac, you can just open the terminal and you can SSH to your rig. Personally, I prefer the terminal because I can copy paste easily, and it's the colors are much better, like than the browser, but it's up to you. So if you type exit on the browser, you just close the session, and then by refreshing, you just go back to the initial page. Now I have I prepare a Word file where I have the initial config that you need to do, so you can secure your rig. You can secure Ethos. Nobody can access it by using a default username password, and also you can set up the conf file. So I wrote the commands here so you can see easily, and if you pause the video. So when you access the first time Ethos, I just type clear. The first time you will see, of course, the time, and Ethos is the user, and the name of the rig, and then you will see the IP and how many hashes you do. So the first thing is to update Ethos. So when if there is a new version available and you access Ethos on the monitor, like as I saw at the beginning, like here, you will see a message around here. You will see a message from Ethos, from the operating system, that a new version is available. So in that case, for example, the version is 1.26. So if 1.27 is available, you will see the message, and then you have the option to update. It's good to update, so because there are some bug fixes and some bug fixes for Ethos as well as bug fixes for the miners. So to update Ethos, I'm not going to type these commands because I already did it, but what you need to do is type sudo and this command. So with this command, you can update Ethos. It take a while, it will take probably 20-30 minutes, depends the size and how many changes they did. And after the finish, as you can see here, is going to restart. The last R means reboot. So when you finish, we reboot your rig. When you access your ring again, if we go back to this page, you can see here that the version will be different. It will be 127 or 128, depends. If for some reason it's not the same, or something happened and it doesn't, the ethos doesn't work properly as supposed to be, what you can do is you can re-update it. So with this command, which Ethos team have in the operating system, is you can re-update your Ethos and then reboot it again. So after this, you should be able to see the correct version. Usually it's very rare to have problem, because obviously they test it and before they release it, but you should be able to see on the top of the main screen up here the new version, the correct version. So if you see the correct version, the next step is to update the miners. So there are a couple of miners already configured and installed in the in Ethos. So with this command, I will show you. With this command, you can see how many miners and the versions. So for example, if we want to use Claymore, which is 10.1, if there is a new version, you can find a new version on Google. If there is version 11, you are not going to see a warning or message from Ethos. They are not going to inform you about minor updates. So what you need to search by yourself, so you just Google it and you will see which version is available. So now if there is a new version, what you need to do is you need to type this command. And with this command we'll update all the miners, not only the Claymore. If there is an update, we'll update it. If there is no update, we'll just leave it at the same version. When you finish when you finish the update, you can type again the same command and then you will see the new versions in the new minor versions. So the first step is just to have your Ethos and miners up to the latest version. So the third step is to disable the remote config. Now remote config is if you have multiple rigs and you want to control everything by using one config, you can use the remote config, and then you can configure all the rigs at the same time. Now if you have one rig and you're not interested to use remote config, you just type force local, this command, and when you type force local, the only thing it's doing is just wiping the remote conf file. Now when you access Ethos, you type pwd, you go to home Ethos, because it's the user that you SSH to, and then you type ls hyphen l, and you can see a couple of files. You can see Claymore, because I'm already using Claymore, so you will be in the home user file folder, but also you can see local conf and the remote conf. As you see, remote conf is zero because I use the force local command. Now if I do cat, the file is empty, as you can see here. So this way is not going to use the remote conf, and then you need to edit and configure local conf so you can you can use the configuration locally for your rig. The step 4 is to change Ethos and root user's password. The user Ethos is using, as everyone knows, password live. So if you type password Ethos, pass wd in Linux is the command to change passwords and the user. So you just need to type the command and the user you want to change the password. So if I type this, it will ask me which is the current password, and the next option will be, the next question will be, which is, it will be the new password. At the moment I don't want to change. And with this way you can change the password for the Ethos user. Also, before you log out or log in again to test it, you need to use to change the password for the root as well, by using sudo and the same command pass wd. You can change the password for the root user. So if I type this, you will see it's asking you which is the new password, and then you have a confirmation, and then at a new password. So I don't need to change, obviously, but I did already. And then you have a new password for the sudo for the root user as well as Ethos, which is a good practice if you are planning to open SSH and allow SSH connection from your rig to internet, and you don't want other people to access your rig and change your wallet. Now, step 4 is the most important part. Step 5 is to edit the local conf. So by editing this file, you can use the commands you want and the options you want. So you can configure the local.conf file and start mining based on what you want to use, which miner and which wallet, etc. To do this, you have to use just vi local.conf. And then you can open your local file and you can edit it. Now, if you use already VI, but if you want to exit and save the file, you just type escape on your keyboard, and then column and write WQ, like write and quit. So by typing escape column WQ, you save and quit the file. So I have here already, I export from my local file. So the local file is, as I saw you before, is in the home Ethos, which is this file here. And the only thing you need to do is to, there are many options if you want to read the whole local file and find which options are suitable for you and your rig. But generally, if you want to quickly start mining by using Nanopool, which is the default pool for Ethos, and Claymore, they have a fee, but is more stable than Ethminer, at least for the AMD cards. So you can use this setup and usually you put at the top of the file. So for example, I will explain you what is each command, each option. The global power tune is the power you want to use for your rig, for your card. For the AMD I think is from 1 to 7. For the NVIDIA is the voltage, for example 120 or 100, depends how much you want to use. Now for AMD, and when I did a couple of tests, I try for example 6 and 7 and also 3, so different values, and I found out 4 is more stable. To find the value for your rig, you have to put it around 4 and 5, leave it for 1 or 2 weeks, and then and monitor your Nanopool website. So when you find your nano, when you find your hashes are stable and your card is stable, then it means that's the correct power tune for your card and your rig. The next one is a global miner, so this is the miner you want to use. So if I show you again the miners, you can see like I want to use Claymore, so I just type Claymore here. And then the next one is the global core. So if you want to change and force your card to overclock the core, you can change it here. The reason I didn't change is because if you adjust the global core, you have to adjust the voltage, so there is a risk there. You have to do your calculations correctly, otherwise you end up having problems. And that's why I left global core as it is, but I adjusted the global memory. And again, this is depends on your card, but for AMD RX 80 I have 2000 was providing better hash. Like I will show you, there's a command that would in Ethos which provide good information is about your card. It's source stats. So source stats, you can see here that your you can see the default core. You can see the default core and default memory. So if you want to find out how much memory you can put, you can see it by using source stats. You can see which is the default value, and then you can see here which is the value you changed to. Next one is a global fan. So with a global fan you can decide how much percentage of the fan you want to use for your whole rig. So 85 means 85%. So you want the fans to go for 85% of the power, and which sometimes can be noisy, but depends also on the weather. Like if it's winter, you don't want to use very high, because also is using more voltage and more watts, so probably you're going to drop a little bit. And if it's hot, you can increase it. Now the maximum GPU temp is the temperature, the maximum temperature that your GPU can reach before Ethos shut it down. So if for example my GPU reaches 75%, that means the Ethos will shut down the specific card. The next one is if you want to use Stratus proxy. Usually is enabled for Claymore, but if you use other third-party exchanges or third-party companies like NiceHash, you have to specify here that you want to use Stratum Proxy NiceHash. Next you have to use your wallet. So now with Nanopool, if you want to change the minimum payment, for example the minimum payment is 0.2 Ethereum, but if you want to drop it to 0.05, you have to type your wallet with this format. So you type your wallet and then dot and then your worker name. So the worker name is, as you see here, when you access Ethos, your worker name is is the letters and numbers after the at. Is the part before the IP. So you just type here your worker, and then slash and your email. So if you don't use the email, you can change your settings in Nanopool. The next is which pools you want to use. These are the default pools that Ethos providing, and this pool is connected with Nanopool. So it depends where you are, you can use EU or you can use USA. One way to find out which one is better is by do a ping. So if I ping EU pool, you can see it's about 20 milliseconds, which is a good speed, and it's a good there's no delay, or is it? Yeah, it's not far at all, 20 milliseconds. But if I use the USA, so bear in mind I'm based in Europe, but if I type ping USA pool, it's slightly higher, 91 milliseconds. But if the pool is busy, it can go up to 100-150 milliseconds, which can create problems with your mining, because if there's a long delay, then you can lose you can lose stakes, and probably you will not mine efficiency as you supposed to or you was hoping to. So it's very important to ping your pools and find out which one is providing you less runtime and less delay. The next one are the flags. Usually this is the default flags. I didn't change them. So you can leave it as it is. But depends again, if you want to use NiceHash, you have to adjust your flags. But usually NiceHash, for example, they already providing you the options, which options to use. Next one is auto reboot. So for auto reboot is if something happened with Ethos, and if the memory crash or there's a software version, the software crash, and then the Ethos will not reboot to recover from the crash, but we continue mining. But if you reach 12 crashes, or if 12 problems occur in the operating system, then Ethos will reboot itself. If the problem is if you drop this to 1 or 2, 1 for example, or 2, and there's a problem with one of the cards, or a card is creating problem to your operating system, then Ethos will restart very often, and of course we create problems to your mining, and then you have to fix the problem. Of course, the solution is not to increase this, but you need to find why this is happening. The last one is the custom panel. So custom panel is the custom panel is how you want to call it, how you want to call your panel, which you can use to see your mining on the web interface. As you remember the first picture, here you can see here this is from the custom panel. This is the first 6 letters and numbers from the custom panel. The first 6 is characters is the name which will appear on the Ethos, on the main page, as you see here, the first 6, and you can use this URL to access your rig from the web interface. So you can see everything. I will show you in a minute the information in this page. But it's a good practice to change it to something more familiar. The other six is the secret, which you need to keep it, of course. Secret is very important to keep to set up this and use your secret as well as your custom name for the custom panel. And you don't need to type any dot between, you just type 6 and 6, for example, 6 characters and then 6 numbers, so everything can be together with no space or nothing between. So after you edit your local file, to save it and start mining, you have to type this command: put conf plus and mine stop. So with this command, your rig, your miners will stop and then we restart again. So when you type this command, you have to check your miners. So for example, if I type show miner, you can see here it's keep refreshing and keep providing more info, but you can see the information you get from the miner, which in my case is Claymore, but you can see the speed, how many shares, very important, if they rejected shares, and how many megahertz per second. Also you can see of course the GPU fan and also the temperature for the GPU. So when you type the command put conf plus plus or and then mine stop, it takes some seconds until it starts launching the miner, and then you will see something similar, this kind of setup. So it depends of course on the miner. If you use ETH miner, it's quite easily different. It doesn't provide all this information, it's just provide you one line with how many hashes you do, but it will be many lines, one after the other. So Claymore's output is easily different. So if you use different global miner, you don't need to worry if it's if you will see different results in the same miner. So these are the 6 steps to set up Ethos and kind of best practices, like update Ethos, update your miners, disable remote conf, update the passwords and change the passwords, and then create your local conf with all the options you want. Local conf have many options, is a big template file, so you can decide what to use. You can remove things, you can add things, is up to you based on what you want to do. And then when you finish, you apply your changes. And then there are a couple of commands, very good commands to know, is show stats, which I show you, where you can see the memory and the default CPU and the default memory clock, and a couple of other information which Ethos is passing through API to NanoPool and other pools. So it's very important to keep to check this, the stats, if you have, especially if you have problems and instabilities. And then show miner, you can see your mining, like a lot of information about your mining per card, per GPU. So if you have 5 GPUs, you will see GPU 0 to GPU 4 or 5 or depends how many you have and how many hashes you do per GPU, which is very important to know this information. Also with Claymore you can do dual mining. For example, you can see here that I'm mining at the moment Ethereum, but also you can mine DCR. And then if you want to reboot your rig, you just type sudo reboot and you reboot your whole rig. So if you have a problem, just use this command to reboot your rig. And the last command is help me, where you can see information about the commands which are available with your Ethos. So you can see which version you have, when this version was released, and also there is a quick start guide. So many of this information I mentioned here you can find in the quick start guide, but not in this kind of priority. Will be a mix. Also you can see a sample config, which is the same as the local.conf, and then a couple of commands like show commands, like show stats if you want to reboot, to force local to disable the remote config. Yeah, if you want to update, which we already saw here, to update the miners and also to update the Ethos. Yeah, the rest of the commands is more related to overclocking and the proxy. You don't need to make changes or mess around with proxies or other commands if you don't have a problem, or if you want, of course, to make changes, you can do it. You can make changes. You can overclock it if you want to force overclock, for example. By using the information in the local conf, you can use this command, or you just reboot your rig. So it's a good practice to set up all this before you start mining. So probably for 1 or 2 days you just check different configs, just to make sure that your rig is stable before you start mining. And then at the bottom of the of the help me, you can see the panel, the status panel. So if I go back to the browser, you can see here this is my current status panel. So you can see the version of Ethos, and then a couple of information like I'm using Claymore and a graphic card. So this is the name of the worker and the IP, and then how many hashes, total number of hashes. If you have many cards, we'll summarize the hashes here. The temperature of the GPU. If you have many GPUs, we will see all the GPUs one after the other. The power tune. So as you see for AMD, you have to use the DPM, which is 1 to 7 or 1 to 8. In my case, 4 is ideal because I tested for 1 week, couple of days with number 7, couple of days number 6, but 4 was more stable. So as you see, I'm hashing with 25 megahash per second, which is stable for about 2 weeks. So it didn't change at all. That's why it's very important to find your correct tune and and your correct memory. Probably you don't need to overclock the core, but you can overclock the memory to provide better performance. So if you point to memory, you can see 1.75 is the default, but I overclocked it to 2. The core is the same, so it's just is the default one. And some information about the fans. And also you can see other things like Ethos providing APIs. If you have many rigs, you can use API to collect information. So this is very important panel, and as you see, the name of the panel, .ethosdistro.com, this name is coming from the custom panel. So the first 6 you're going to type here will be the name of your rig in the Ethos distro. So you only have to do, if you have your rig in your local network, you have to open port 80 and allow port 80 HTTP from inside and outside, so you can access this website outside your house or outside your the place where you have the ring in the public internet. So this is all. This is the first setup with Ethos and how to configure it properly for the first time and start mining with your GPUs by using Claymore. The next video I'm going to show you how to connect everything, the motherboards, GPU, in the right way, because some people are using adapters, SATA adapters, but I will show you how to connect it with Molex and by using also GPU cables, power cables, and also I will create another video how to mount and install Ethos in SSD and launch it, then connect it to your rig and launch it. Okay, thank you for watching.